Hello, business builders. I'm very excited to be here. It's Natalie Fuller from the cold Canada. We've got snow on the ground and I'm looking forward to getting back to Florida. Hey, I'm here to talk to you about December. And December is one of those months that some people just take it by the horns and they say, I'm going to do whatever I can this month. And we see advancements. You'll see advancements this month. And then there's a whole lot of people who say it's December. I can't get anybody to do anything. Well, first of all, we all know that our group and our team respond to our own attitude. But there are things, without a doubt, that make December more challenging. But it's also a really exciting month for you to put the 2016 year behind you and put it to bed like we do our gardens and get ready to open up the new year. And it's an important activity, at least at the psychological level. It's really important that we do this. So here's the first thing I want you guys all to do this month, because you're gonna have time. I know it's busy with Christmas activities and all the social things and all the family things you have on, but you're gonna have quiet times. And I would like you to schedule some quiet time. Get yourself a glass of wine, get yourself a tea, get a notebook, and really, really evaluate 2016. And you can do that in all aspects of your life, your personal life, your family life, your physical health life. You can do it in other areas. But at least in your plexus business, I want you to take time to really evaluate 2016. I want you to look at your report. You can go to your key measures and go back the 6 months and get good detailed information. But I want you to look at all the things that worked amazing. What were your best growth months? When were the months you were the most excited? What months weren't very exciting? What months did you go backwards? Look at the things you were doing in the months that worked and the months that didn't work. How were you feeling? What else was going on in your life in those months? And maybe you can get a little bit of a handle on who you are and what makes you tick and what gets you excited and what gets you enthusiastic and how affected are you by other things that are going on in your life. And maybe you'll have to think of new strategies to get through some of those more challenging months that you may have with things outside of your plexus business. Whatever it is, take time to really look at 2016 and look at all the things that you did to grow your business and ask yourself which ones were the most effective and what are the things that maybe you don't want to do again that didn't really help your team to respond. Once you have all of 2016 evaluated, put to bed, and you've got a clear picture of what you did well and what things you didn't do so well, when you were good and when you weren't so good, sign it off. Give yourself permission to put that away, close that book, and now start fresh with 2017, but with a little bit of inventory in your pocket, because you now know the things that worked. You knew the way you were behaving that got things that were good, going well. Maybe, for example, I haven't been doing, ever since I tore my ACL, I've let myself really slip physically. But I know when I'm working out, and I know when I'm feeling good, better physically, everything else about my business is stronger. So that's one of the first things I need to do, is address my physical health and get myself back working into shape. Okay, now the work begins for 2017. First thing I'd love you guys all to do is take some time to schedule some brainstorming. Whether you can do that with three or four other people, maybe you've got some peers that are cross-lined to you at the same level you are at, maybe you've got some key team members, but do some brainstorming. Brainstorming is incredibly powerful as long as it's done in a safe environment where everybody can just throw ideas out there with no judgment and look at what are the things you can do to move the needle of your business forward in 2017. What are the activities that need to get on your calendar in order for you to move forward? Now, we all know doing your income-producing activity is first and foremost on there. But for example, maybe you've got some key team members that want to move forward. And so your goal in the next few days or the next week or two is to get your calendar and their calendar synced up with activities that you're going to do together to help them move forward. You're not going to wait to January to fill the calendar. You want your calendar right through to next summer really jammed full of activities that's going to move the needle of your business forward. So you're going to do some brainstorming. Fill those pages with content. Content being activities that are going to move your business. Decide on the most important things. Maybe even come up with some promotion ideas, even when you might want to run some of those promotion ideas, maybe around Super Saturday, maybe a promotion around convention. But make things sure those things are in your calendar. Make sure everybody's putting convention on their calendar. Maybe some some good videos or some reminders on your team page about upcoming corporate events. I want you to get your Zoom calendar, your Sip and Share calendar. I want all of that starting to get filled out. So when January 1 hits, you hit your with your feet running because you've already got your calendar filled. That's really, really important. I want you to really think about, though, that what we do right now really prepares us for 2017. So, for example, you may be hearing things like, oh, you know, it's Christmas. It's not really a good time for me to get on the products. How about changing their attitude and saying, I would love for you to join us in a challenge on January 1. I'm going to be doing this Slim and Block challenge, whatever it is, a triplex challenge. We're putting a group together. What I'd really love you to do is just order the product, stick it in your cupboard. Even if you're not feeling like it's the right time to start it, I would challenge you it is, but if you think it's the best time to start with in January, you're going to pull it out on January 1. And do I have permission to send you a little bit of a reminder on New Year's Day to pull out those products? I would ask everybody in your team to find one partner, one or two challenge partners, to join them in a product challenge on January 1st. It's when we're all making our resolutions anyway. But you want it in their cupboard, ready to launch on January 1. Maybe that's something we could all do together. The other thing I want you to think about, and this was somebody reminded me of this today. If you have new people, ambassadors that you're talking to, and they're saying they'd like to start maybe in January, what if you suggested to them that December's the best time for them to buy their welcome pack and their membership kit, because they're going to be able to write this off in their taxes in just a few months? You see, if they wait till January, they have to wait a whole year before they're going to be able to write that expense off. So there's a real advantage financially to buy it now in December and know that you're going to get the tax benefits of that when they file their taxes. So another reason to pick up the phone, and call people and say, hey, you know what? I just had a thought. You were talking about waiting till January, but I was just reminded that there's real tax benefits in being able to do it this month. Maybe that's something we could talk about. Okay, I think those are the things that I really wanted to talk to you about. Find the time to put 2016 to sleep. Find the time to get your plans in place for 2017. Call everybody you know and invite them to be in a challenge with you in January with our products when people are doing their New Year's resolutions. Decide who your key business partners are that you're going to be working with and get things on the calendar with them. Help them to take advantage of the promotion that's just been put in place by corporate. But on those times that you're not as busy as you normally would be because of Christmas season, you fill it with activities that are going to move 2017 in the direction you want quickly. You don't want to wait till the first of the month and get that all revved up, because it'll take people to the middle of the month in order to get started. But you don't want to waste the month of January. So guys, let's make December the best month. And let's plan, let's prepare, and let's put 2016 to bed.